we shall now prove a theorem. The statement of the theorem is every field is an integral domain. We all know what is a field. So to prove every field is an integral domain, we choose an arbitrary field. Let F be a field. The definition of field is, suppose we take the ordered triplets or the algebraic structure F comma plus comma dot, then F comma plus is abelian group, F minus 0 comma dot is abelian. That is, this given set is abelian with respect to multiplication. Here we have written minus 0 because inverse, we should not consider inverse of 0. That is, inverse exists for every non-zero element of F. That is the meaning of F minus singleton set 0. 0 is considered in all other cases except while we finding the inverse with respect to multiplication. That is, the ordered pair or the algebraic structure F minus 0 element comma dot dot stands for multiplication is abelian and satisfies distributive laws. That is, 5 plus 5 plus 1, 11 axioms are satisfied. Now what you have to prove? We have to show that F is an integral domain. What is an integral domain? We know that an integral domain is a commutative ring with unity without zero devices. Therefore, a commutative ring with unity without zero devices is called an integral domain. Now, we should see the difference between field and integral domain. Field has 11 axioms, whereas commutative ring has only, ring means 8 axioms. That is, R comma plus is a ring, R comma dot is semi-distributive law. So 8, commutative is 9, unity is 10, 10 without zero devices is 11. That is, both are having same number of axioms. But what's the difference? The only difference is, in a field, every non-zero element has inverse. That property is not there in integral domain. Similarly, in integral domain, without zero divisor concept is there, but this is not there in a field. So only difference is, here every non-zero element has inverse in a field, which is not there in integral domain. Integral domain is having the property, namely without zero divisors, which is not there in the field. Therefore, if you want to show that F is a integral domain, since F is a commutative ring with unity, therefore, in order to show that every field is an integral domain, we should show that a field has no zero divisors. This example of zero divisors, without zero divisors. That is, A is not equal to 0, B is not equal to 0 implies AB not equal to 0. Or A is 0, B is 0 implies A into B equal to 0. This is a concept of without zero divisors. Therefore, in this theorem, we have to show that field has no zero divisors. Suppose that A comma B belong to F, where F is a field with A is not equal to 0, such that A into B equals to 0. We know that whenever A B equal to 0, either A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. That's a general case. Now we have assumed that AB equal to 0 and A is not equal to 0. To show that F has no zero divisors, we have to show that AB equal to 0 implies B B must be zero. Because AB equal to zero implies either A zero or B zero. Since here we are taken A is not equal to zero, this must show that B equal to zero. So now our aim is to show that B equals to zero. So let us start with AB equals to zero. Since A is not equal to zero, A inverse exists. A inverse exists. Since A is not equal to zero, A inverse exists. Now we are given A into B equal to zero. Now we pre-multiply by A inverse. That is, multiply both sides by A inverse. We know associative property. Associative property is to change the bracket. Therefore, here we have A inverse, A into B, that can be written as A inverse into A into B equals to zero. A inverse into A, this is B, that is equals to A inverse into zero is zero. What is A inverse into A? A inverse into A is nothing but identity. Therefore, we take the identity is one, and hence one into B equal to zero. What is one into B? One is the identity, therefore it implies B equals to zero. Thus, AB equal to zero implies B equal to zero. Therefore, F is without zero divisors. Here we assume that A is not equal to zero. AB equal to zero implies B equal to zero. In the next case, we are going to assume that B is not equal to zero. And AB equal to zero implies A equal to zero. That's the next case. Similarly, suppose that A comma B belong to F with B is not equal to zero, such that AB equal to zero. Now our aim is to show that A equals to zero. Since B is not equal to zero, we know that in a field inverse exists for every non-zero element. Therefore, B is a non-zero element, inverse exists, let us call it as B inverse. Now, AB equal to 0 is given. Now, post multiplied by B inverse, that is multiplied B inverse on both sides, and we are going to apply associative property as we have done in the previous case, and 0 into B inverse is 0. Therefore, A into B into B inverse. We know that B into B inverse is the identity. Therefore, A into 1 equal to 0. Being 1 is the identity, A into 1 is equals to A. So, A equal to 0. Thus, we have taken AB equal to 0. Now, we have shown that A equal to 0. In this case also, F is without 0 divisors. Thus, in a field F, AB equal to 0 implies either A equal to 0, the case of 2, or B equal to 0 in case number 1. In case number 1, we have shown that B equal to 0. Case number 2, we assume that AB equal to 0 and we have shown that A equal to 0. Therefore, if we combine both cases in a field, if AB equal to 0, then we have A equal to 0 or B equals to 0. Therefore, we say that a field has no zero divisors. Therefore, every field is an integral domain. Note, the converse is not true. That is, every integral domain need not be a field. Just now we have shown that every field is an integral domain. But the converse is every integral domain need not be a field. That means there are some integral domain which are field. There are some integral domain which are field. Therefore, we have to say the statement as every integral domain need not be a field. For example, the ring of integers, namely z comma plus comma dot, this is a ring where Z stands for ring of integers, is an integral domain and it is not a field. Why it is not a field? Because every non-zero element has no multiplicative inverse. In fact, it has only two elements which have multiple multiplicative inverses. That is, the only invertible elements of the ring of integers are 1 and minus 1. That is, if you take any other element other than 1 and minus 1, the multiplicative inverse does not exist. That is, if 2 belongs to Z, 2 inverse is equal to 1 by 2, which is not in Z. Therefore, Z comma plus comma dot is not a field. So the converse is not true. That is, every field is an integral domain, but every integral domain need not be a field. But the next theorem is very interesting theorem, in which there's a particular type of integral domain must be a field. Now the theorem says a field, a skew field, has no zero divisors.